Thank you, and welcome to Phony Learn. We appreciate all our subscribers and viewers. Today, we shall learn how to set multiple actions in one button while mixing and scratching on Virtual DJ. I am going to search and load a song or a track onto Deck 1. Once it is loaded, I can drag to a proper start point where I can do my mixing and scratching. Remember, if you have set your cue points, you can simply use the Alt key plus the cue point number to switch to it. Let's confirm our start point. In our last video, we set D and G to perform a back and forward scratch respectively. We also set letter A to go back to cue point, and used A, together with G to perform the stab scratch. Please remember to like, subscribe, and ring the notification bell for more updates. Alright, those are just single actions for each button. Now, we shall set the Y keyboard button to perform the forward scratch when pressed, and back scratch if released. Find the configuration button on your top right corner, and open the controllers tab. Click on the box labeled key, and type letter Y. Go down there, and click the action box. Type down, space, question mark, scratch, another space, plus 120 milliseconds. Put a space, and a colon, and then type scratch, space, minus 120 milliseconds. Please check your action by hovering the mouse over the text. It should appear like this if typed correctly. Save and close the configurations. Let's test our Y button. Great. Now let us set an action for letter F to scratch forward when pressed, and go back to cue point when released. Confirm whether the action is typed correctly, and then save and exit. Let us test our letter F. Perfect. You can use letter F and Y now. And now, this is a bonus because you were patient enough to watch to this point. I will show you how to use the keyboard to activate audio effects. But first, we shall set echo properly for this tutorial. Make sure the strength is at most 30%, and the length is half beat. Ignore the rest of the settings, or copy mine. Don't mute the source. Let's go to configurations and set our audio effects activator buttons. Set this action for cue. Effect. Underscore, active, space, and then 1. That means Q will activate the first audio effect here, which is echo. Set W to activate the effect number 2, which is delay, in our case here. And finally, set E to activate the effect number 3, which is a high filter here. When you are done, save and close the configurations. Watch what happens as I press Q, W, and E. We can try the echo now. That's all for today. As usual, I'll leave you with this for practice.